Okay, time to go across once again to Dictionary Corner. Greg, what have you got for us?
When I was an educator, as I was for many years, I was fortunate enough that there was a guest speaker at the school that I taught at, and it was the ex-champion boxer Chris Eubank. he very kindly came in for nothing to inspire the children, and he did a 3.5-hour lecture to them. that it was unusual, and it consisted of him telling some loose anecdotes, but he interspersed them with very aggressive poems that he'd made up himself, which he... which he shouted into the children's faces. and it, you know, it was really inspiring. Anyway, I realised afterwards, I didn't think I could do impressions, I've never been able to do impressions, that I can do an incredible impression of Chris Eubank. And because he inspired me that day, I've realised that classic works of literature sound better through Eubank's voice.
What a wonderful treat for us all.
I thought I'd present some to you. And before I do, I would tell you that my agent and every member of production I've spoken to on this show has made it very clear they think this is a terrible idea.
That's coming after jumping on people.
I take a while to get Chris's voice, so bear with me. I have to...
it was the best of times.
Please, a little bit of culture, please.
It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom. It was the age of foolishness.
Thank you very much.
I mean, the sad thing is, it's actually a very good Nelson Mandela.
Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate. Rough winds just...
You sound like one of the Compare the Maker. So.
If Chris Eubank was here, he wouldn't be offended.
You know what, Greg? Say pugilist a few times. That seems
that gets me in right.
That's his key word.
I wasn't a fighter, I was a pugilist. Are you talking to me? Well, then who the hell are you talking to?
You sound like a villain in Danger Mouse. That's what you said.
Yes, it's Iwan! I know what you're thinking.
I'm finished.
Fucking hell, John!
It's one of the worst impressions ever.
I know what you're thinking. Did he fire 6 shots or 5? Well, tell you the truth, it's... all this excitement, I kind of lost track myself. You've got to ask yourself one question. Do you feel lucky? Do you think? My name is Maximus.
I think I've made my point, Jimmy. Yeah.
Very moving, actually. Crying quite a bit. Genuinely one of the worst impressions, I think. I mean, it's OK to say as well, when we go to Dictionary Corner, it's OK to say, I don't have a talent, so just move on.
If they were my fault, I'd have they whipped for being old before that time.
Oh, God, again. I'm so sorry, it's so unprofessional.
What you're doing is unprofessional.
That's professional. You call that professional?
I mean, literally 2 hours ago, I was speaking to my agent and he went, I don't know, Greg, is it that good, your impression?
OK, now, before we get on with the game, last time you were on the show, Greg, you did an incredible impersonation of Chris Eubank.
Correct.
No.
Yeah, and I've had lots of people come up to me in the street and say that they thought Sean was extremely harsh on my impression, and that it is indeed the greatest Chris Eubank impression of all time.
I've got some famous sort of speeches for you. Could you give us a little bit more of the Chris Eubanks? Because it's pretty extraordinary.
Are you joking? I was born to do it.
Okay, Holly, could you pass those over to... It's an incredible voice.
It's bliss. Okay.
We shall fight them on the beach. We shall fight them on the beach, yes. We shall fight them on the landing ground. We shall never surrender.
It's good, but I feel there's more.
Now is the winter of our discontent. Made glorious summer by this son of York.
Why are you making me do this again?
I really like it. It does sound brilliant, but you're not the only person that does a brilliant Chris Eubank. I've got someone here who does the voice, I mean, pretty bloody well. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Chris Eubank.
It's cool. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
It is indeed the greatest form of theatre.
I'm so frightened. I'm so, so frightened.
Chris, what do you think of the impression?
It's wonderful. The fact that he cannot hold a straight face, it means it's fantastic. It works.
It is. I bet if we covered Sean's eyes, and Chris and I both...
I have something for you. So this is the challenge. I have a tongue twister for you, gentlemen. You could pass that down. That's a tongue twister for both Chris Eubanks. And Sean is going to cover his eyes and try and establish which one is reading.
OK. First, he killed the Misha Mokwa, greatest bear of all the mountains.
From the skin.
It's okay, so the other guy has a go.
From the skin.
Made them with the fur side inside. Made them with the skin side outside.
To get the warm side inside, he put the inside side aside. Why?
He put the skin side outside.
Why?
He turned them inside
out. Outside.
Who was that?
Who was that?
Yeah.
That was Chris. And then Greg, sort of, every now and again.
And
who else?
Vic.
Maybe you're not quite as good at guessing who Chris Eubank is as you think you are.
Ladies and gentlemen, Chris Eubank, everyone!
Incidentally, can I just say to all the people involved in the production, you pricks. I shat myself.